Good morning and welcome to our Easter Day service of Holy Communion here at St. George's Church in East Ivanhoe, Melbourne. A very warm welcome to our parishioners and those of you who may be friends of family and friends and friends of this community around the world. We particularly welcome you on this most holy of days. May this time of Easter bring you much joy, peace and hope. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Blessed be God's kingdom now and forever.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Christ is risen. Alleluia.
He is risen indeed. Alleluia.
Let us pray. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest, and peace to God's people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Glorious Lord of life, by the mighty resurrection of your Son, you overcame the old order of sin and death to make all things new in him. Grant that we who celebrate with joy Christ's rising from the dead may be raised from the death of sin to the life of righteousness, through him who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Then Peter began to speak to them. I truly understand that God shows no partiality, but in every nation, anyone who fears him and does what is right is acceptable to him. You know the message he sent to the people of Israel, preaching peace by Jesus Christ. He is Lord of all. That message spread throughout Judea, beginning in Galilee after the baptism that John announced, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and with power, how he went about doing good and healing all who were oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. We are witnesses to all that he did, both in Judea and Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging him on a tree. But God raised him on the third day and allowed him to appear, not to all the people, but to us who were chosen by God as witnesses and who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commanded us to preach to the people and to testify that he is the one ordained by God as judge of the living and the dead. All the prophets testify about him, that everyone who believes in him receives forgiveness of sins through his name. Hear the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Psalm 118. O give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His mercy endures forever.
Let Israel now proclaim that his mercy endures forever.
The Lord is my strength and my song, and has become my salvation.
The sounds of joy and deliverance are in
the
tents of the righteous.
The right hand of the Lord does mighty things. The right hand of the Lord raises up.
I shall not die but live, and proclaim the works of the Lord.
The Lord has disciplined me hard, but he has not given me over to death.
Open me the gates of righteousness, and I will enter and give thanks to the Lord.
This is the gate of the Lord. The righteous shall enter it.
I will praise you, for you answered me, and have become my salvation.
The stone that the builders rejected has become the head of the corner.
This is the Lord's doing, and it is marvelous in our eyes.
This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Glory to God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
As in the beginning, so now and forever. Amen.
A reading from the Epistle of Paul to the Colossians. So, if you have been raised with Christ, seek the things that are above, where Christ is, seated at the right hand of God. Set your mind on things that are above, not on things that are on earth. For you have died, and your life is hidden with Christ in God. When Christ, who is your life, is revealed, then you also will be revealed with him in glory. Hear the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Christ, our Paschal Lamb, has been sacrificed. Let us then feast with joy in the Lord. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Matthew. Glory to you, Lord Jesus Christ. After the Sabbath, as the first day of the week was dawning, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary went to see the tomb. And suddenly there was a great earthquake, for an angel of the Lord, descending from heaven, came and rolled back the stone and sat on it. His appearance was like lightning, and his clothing white as snow. For fear of him, the guards shook and became like dead men. But the angel said to the women, "Do not be afraid. I know that you are looking for Jesus who was crucified. He is not here, for he has been raised as he said. Come, see the place where he lay. Then go quickly and tell his disciples, he has been raised from the dead, and indeed he is going ahead of you to Galilee. There you will see him. This is my message for you." So they left the tomb quickly with fear and great joy and ran to tell his disciples. Suddenly Jesus met them and said, "Greetings." And they came to him, took hold of his feet, and worshipped him. Then Jesus said to them, Do not be afraid. Go and tell my brothers to go to Galilee. There they will see me. This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise
to you, Lord Jesus Christ. May the words of my lips and the meditations of our hearts be always acceptable in your sight, O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. Some brief words of reflection on this joyous Easter day. When I think of some of the great plays of history and a few plays I've heard and seen in the theatres of the world, I'm reminded that with great theatre, each character and scene serves a purpose. The scenes, the dialogue of the characters, shape our experience as an audience. They guide us to the essential message or essence of the story of the playwright. And as good theatre and drama builds scene upon scene, we eventually reach the climax of the story. Great theatre grips us, moves us, and shapes us. The stories of Scripture and Holy Week, from Palm Sunday to Good Friday, to the tragedy of the cross and the joy of the resurrection, each scene serves a purpose. Each character serves a purpose as they act as signs to guide us, the contemporary audience, to the eternal truth and essence of this story. That in the historical Jesus of Nazareth, heaven and earth came together. And in the story of Jesus of Nazareth, all that separates us from God was removed once and for all. When we've watched great theatre, we leave the theatre and we talk to those who've accompanied us about our experience of the play and its impact and how it shapes and guides us. On this Easter day, the truth of this story is that we are now invited to be the actors in a great play in the history of the world. Where we live, work, and play is our stage. We are the characters upon those scenes. We now are invited, indeed called, to act as signs that point to the essential truth of this story. And like actors in a great play, we have a greater and deeper purpose. In addition to being signs, we're called to be agents of change, to change the world in which we live. In this time of pandemic around the world, as I said on Friday, we have a perverse opportunity to revisit the way in which we live our individual lives, lives as family, as communities, as nations. Now, more than ever, we are called to be signs and agents of change. As one great scholar has said, to turn the world the right way up, to turn the world God's way up, where all answer a call to be in relationship with one another, with the created order, with God herself. Our challenge today is that when social distancing and isolation methods or restraints are lifted, that we go back out into the world full of the message of this story, full of love and peace, looking to bring justice to the world. Let us, on this day, on this joyous day, commit ourselves once more to be great people of faith, to be signposts and agents of change, so that this world may be truly reconciled to one another and to God. And now may the peace and joy of God be with you wherever you may be, now and always. And now I invite you, where you are able to, wherever you may find yourself this day, to stand with me as we together affirm the faith of the Church Universal. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made, and for us and for our salvation he came down from heaven, was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and of the Holy Spirit, and became truly human. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us pray for the world and for the Church. As disciples who know that Christ is risen, let us pray for the Church and for the world. Bountiful God, as your Church rejoices this day in the resurrection of her Lord and Saviour, may her worship be reverent and her proclamation faithful. Hear our prayers as we pray for Justin, Archbishop of Canterbury, Philip, Archbishop of Melbourne, and for the Right Reverend Dr. Geoffrey Driver, Archbishop of Adelaide, newly elected Primate of the Anglican Church here in Australia. And for our own Bishop, Bishop Geneve. May every Christian soul respond in faith to the call of the Master and make haste to tell the good news. Lord, in your mercy. Bountiful God, let the Easter hope be known in all the world in this time of pandemic. Give light to those who seek assurance to those who doubt, and peace to all the nations of the world. May Christ be known as the only Lord, the only hope of the nations. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Bountiful God, bless our prayer and partner in mission, the mission to seafarers Victoria, and all who minister to those at sea. Keep their welcome warm and their love and care unstinted. May their ministry express the love of Christ for all people. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Bountiful God, be with our families and friends and all who share with us the wonderful day of resurrection. May the presence of Christ bring us close to those who are separated from us, in the knowledge that no distance can part us from his love. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Bountiful God, have mercy on those who stand at the open door of faith, but are held back by doubt or fear of their unworthiness. Draw them in, that they may begin the new life that Christ has brought. Help and comfort those who are sick, and for whom suffering and sorrow mar the happiness of this day. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Bountiful God, we pray for those who, having shared with Christ the death of the body, now share with him the eternal life of his resurrection, as we remember those who have died in recent days, particularly those who have died as a consequence of the pandemic, and those who have died alone and afraid. May the promise that has been fulfilled in them be our hope in this world and our place in the world to come, as we remember with love and affection those whose anniversary of death occurs at this time. Rest eternal grant unto them, O Lord, and let light perpetual shine upon them. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
We pray in the name of Christ who conquered death, that we might live forever. Almighty God, you have promised to hear our prayers. Grant that what we have asked in faith, we may by your grace receive, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Jesus said, I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me will never be hungry, and whoever believes in me will never be thirsty. Let us pray. We do not presume to come to your table, merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in your manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to gather up the crumbs under your table, but you are the same, Lord, whose nature is always to have mercy. Grant us therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of your dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that we may evermore dwell in him, and he in us. Amen. Christ, our Passover Lamb, has been offered for us. Therefore we come to celebrate the festival. Let us confess our sins in penitence and faith with a sincere and a true heart. Merciful God, our Maker and our Judge, we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, and in what we have failed to do. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We repent and are sorry for all our sins. Father, forgive us. Strengthen us to love and obey you in newness of life. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Almighty God, who has promised forgiveness to all who turn to him in faith, pardon you and set you free from all your sins, strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in eternal life. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We are the body of Christ.
His Spirit is with us.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have these gifts to share. Accept and use our offerings for your glory and for the service of your kingdom.
Blessed be God forever.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
All glory and honour be yours always and everywhere, mighty Creator, ever-living God. We give you thanks and praise for your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ, who by the power of your Spirit was born of Mary and lived as one of us. By his death on the cross he offered the one true sacrifice for sin and obtained an eternal deliverance for his people. And now we give you thanks that you raised him to life triumphant and exalted him in glory. By his victory over death, the reign of sin is ended, a new day has dawned, a broken world is restored, and we are made whole once more. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we proclaim your great and glorious name, forever praising you and saying, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Merciful God, we thank you for these gifts of your creation, this bread and wine. And we pray that by your word and Holy Spirit, we who eat and drink them may be partakers of Christ's body and blood. On the night he was betrayed, Jesus took bread, and when he had given you thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat. This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. After supper, he took the cup and again, giving you thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Drink from this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me." Let us proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Therefore, we do as our Saviour has commanded, proclaiming his offering of himself made once for all upon the cross, his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension. And looking for his coming again, we celebrate with this bread and this cup his one perfect and sufficient sacrifice for the sins of the whole world. Renew us by your Holy Spirit, unite us in the body of your Son, and bring us with all your people into the joy of your eternal kingdom. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, with whom and in whom, in the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, we worship you, Father, in songs of never-ending praise. Blessing and honour and glory and power are yours forever and ever. Amen. As our Saviour Christ has taught us, we are confident to pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. We who are many are one body, for we all share in the one bread. Jesus, Lamb of God, have mercy on us. Jesus, bearer of our sins, have mercy on us. Jesus, Redeemer of the world, grant us your peace. Jesus is the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those who are called to his supper. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and I shall be healed. Let us pray. Eternal God, giver of life, in the breaking of the bread we know the risen Lord. May we who celebrate this holy feast walk in his risen light and bring new life to all creation. Father, we offer ourselves to you as a living sacrifice. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, send us out in the power of your Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory. Amen. Well, good morning to you all once more, and a very, very happy Easter to you, wherever you may be watching us around the world or here at home in Australia. You may find our Pew Bulletin on our Facebook page and on our website at stgeorgeseastivanhoe.org. In the week ahead, we will continue to support and sustain one another by sharing our stories, and those stories and reflections and other materials and music that you find helpful will continue to be posted on our Facebook page. And the music and services will continue to be posted on our YouTube channel, which is St. George's Peace Memorial Church, East Ivanhoe. I'm very grateful to those who've undertaken a ministry of contact through our telephone tree and who have began calling people over the last 7 to 10 days. I know that that ministry is very much appreciated. We'll continue to support one another in the weeks ahead, and in about a week's time we'll start to convene our first meeting of our end of COVID street party, which we pray will take place in the weeks and months ahead. If you're interested in assisting with the planning and preparation for that party, please let me know. Make contact via the email address or by telephone or text. May this day be one of renewal and refreshment for you all. We will journey through this together, and at the end we will be a stronger, more loving and gracious community here in Melbourne. And we'll continue to exercise that ministry of hospitality that is a character of this place to the world. The God of peace, who brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus, the great shepherd of the sheep, through the blood of the everlasting covenant, make you perfect in every good work to do his will, working in you what is pleasing in his sight. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you now and always. Go in the peace of Christ. Alleluia, alleluia. Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia.